of this afternoon session. Anna Jové will speak about dynamics on the boundary of Fatou components.
So hello, and first I want to say thank you to the organizers for giving me the opportunity to speak here. And as he said, I will speak about the dynamics on the boundary of Fatou components, which was my master's thesis under the supervision of Professor Núria Fageira. So I'm going to iterate a holomorphic function, which can be either an entire function or a rational function. And as usual, we are going to consider the Fatou set and the Julia set and the escaping set. And in this talk, more concretely, we are going to deal with the Fatou components, which are the connected components of the Fatou set. So we are going to deal only with simply connected and invariant Fatou components, which can be classified in four different types. Attracting basins, when there is an attracting point inside the Fatou component and all orbits tend to it. A parabolic basin, where the fixed point is in the boundary. A single disk, when the function inside the Fatou component is conjugate to an irrational rotation. And a Baker domain, where with the case of when the function is transcendental and iterates converts to infinity. And observe that since we are considering only the simply connected invariant ones, there are so wandering domains are not inside this classification because they are not invariant, and not Hermann rings because they are not simply connected. So to study the dynamics inside the Fatou component, one thing that one can do is to conjugate the dynamics of F inside U to the dynamics of a self-map of the unit disk via the Riemann map. So since our Fatou component is simply connected, one can consider the Riemann map between the unit disk and the Fatou component, and this gives the conjugacy. And to study holomorphic self-maps of the unit disk, we have powerful tools. For instance, the Denjoa-Wolf theorem that says that whenever we have a holomorphic self-map of the unit disk, which is not a rotation, then all orbits converge to the same point, which can be inside the unit disk or in the boundary. And observe that this is precisely what the previous theorem says. So if the function in U is not conjugate to a rotation, so if it is not a single disk, then there exists a point inside, in the case of the attracting basins, where all orbits converge to it, or otherwise this point is in the boundary, in the case of the parabolic basins and of the Baker domains. But to study holomorphic self-maps of the unit disk, we have a more powerful tool, which is Cohen's classification, which describes the dynamics more precisely. So if we have a holomorphic self-map of the disk, which is not conjugate to a rotation, then there exists an absorbing domain. That an absorbing domain is simply a domain such that it is forward invariant and such that all orbits eventually enter to it. And in this absorbing domain, the dynamics are conjugate to a Möbius transformation. And then up to conformal conjugacy, we only have four possibilities. The first one is the one when the Denjoa-Wolf point is inside the unit disk, and then the map is conjugate to a homotacy of the complex plane. And the other three possibilities are when the Denjoa-Wolf point is in the boundary. So it can be conjugate to a translation in the complex plane, in this case is the doubly parabolic case, or it can be conjugate to a homotacy of the upper half plane, which is the hyperbolic case. And the last one is the simply parabolic case when it is conjugate to a translation in the upper half plane. So with this, we can describe more precisely the dynamic inside of a Fatou component. So in the case of the single disk, we have nothing to say because we already know that the dynamics are conjugate to an irrational rotation. In the case of an attracting basin, since the interval point of the associated self-map of the unit disk is inside the unit disk, they are of elliptic type. And in the case of a parabolic basin, although a priori one can think that the three possibilities of convergence to the boundary may happen, this is not true, and one can prove using Fatou coordinates that they are always of doubly parabolic type. But for the case of Baker domains, the three possibilities may happen, and this gives a classification of the Baker domains. So now that we know how the dynamics act inside the Fatou component, we are going to address the question of this talk. So what are the dynamics in the boundary of U? And one might think that if we have studied the function inside the unit disk to know things about the function inside the Fatou component, one can study the function in the boundary of the unit disk to know things of the function in the boundary of the Fatou component. But this has problems because G and phi may not be defined on the boundary of the unit disk. So in the case when F has infinite degree on U, the map G has also infinite degree on D. So there must be at least one point in the boundary where the function is not defined. So we have a problem with this. And on the other hand, phi may not extend to the boundary because there's this theorem by Cara-Theodori that says that if the boundary of U is not locally connected, then the map does not extend continuously. So we have to deal with these problems. First, regarding G, what we are going to do is, instead of considering the image for the points in the boundary of the unit circle, we are going to consider the radial limit, which is precisely the limit taken along the radius. And there's this theorem by Fatou that says that almost every radial limit exists. And the thing is that we have our originally Fatou component, and F extending the boundary of the Fatou component to the boundary of the Fatou component, because the Julia set is invariant. So our self map of the unit disk has to preserve this. So it has to send the unit circle to the unit circle, at least when this is defined. So the associated self-maps of the unit disk are always inner functions, which are precisely the holomorphic self-map of the unit disk, which sends the unit circle to the unit circle almost everywhere. And for inner functions, we have that G star, so the map defined of the radial limit, defines a dynamical system of almost everywhere in the unit circle. So in each iteration, we lose a set of zero measures where the function may not be defined. But since the countable union of sets of zero measure has zero measure, for almost every point in the unit circle, we have an infinite orbit. So it makes sense to consider this dynamical system. But this dynamical system is defined by a function which may not even be continuous. So we need some tools to study this function, which came from the ergodic theory. So a map is said to be ergodic if whenever we have a measurable set which is backwards invariant, it has either zero measure or full measure. And this in some sense is similar to topological transitivity, but instead for open sets is for measurable sets. And a map is said to be recurrent if when we have a measurable set A, then almost every point in A returns to A infinitely many times. And this is related to holomorphic dynamics. For instance, with this theorem here that says that whenever we have a map which is ergodic and recurrent, then almost every point has a dense orbit. So studying ergodicity and recurrence helps us to find points with dense orbit. And now that we know how to deal with G, we have to know what to do with phi. And what we're going to do is to consider in the boundary of U the harmonic measure, which is the image of the Lebesgue measure in the unit circle under phi, under the Riemann map. So this does not depend on which Riemann map we choose, because all these harmonic measures are equivalent. And the advantage of this measure is that we only have to study the boundary map G star, because if it is ergodic or it is recurrent, the same properties hold for F in the boundary of U with respect to the harmonic measure. And here, this table summarizes the ergodicity and recurrence for the different Fatou components. And what is important for the rest of the talk is basically that in the doubly parabolic case, which can correspond either to parabolic basins or Baker domains, the map is always ergodic, and it may be or maybe not be recurrent. So there are examples of ergodic doubly parabolic, recurrent doubly parabolic maps or non-recurrent doubly parabolic maps, but in the case of finite degree, they are always recurrent. And now I'm going to change the topic of the talk, and we're going to study this concrete example, which is z plus z to the minus z, which has this dynamical plane that you can see. And as we will see later, this has infinitely many Baker domains of doubly parabolic type and degree two. So the boundary map for them is both ergodic and recurrent. So almost every point has a dense orbit. And what we want to do is to describe more explicitly the sets of full measure and zero measure that we know that they exist, but we want to find them explicitly. So to study this function, we start by considering this semi-conjugacy, which semi-conjugates our map F with this map H, which is W multiplied by E to the minus W. And studying this other map H is more easy, because we have that, if one computes the fixed points, we see that zero is a parabolic fixed point for H. And this map has only two singular values, which are zero and one over E. And one over E converts to zero under iteration, and zero is fixed. And since we have a finite number of singular values, there are no wandering domains and no Baker domains. And then the Fatou set is precisely the parabolic basin of zero, which consists in infinitely many connected components, and we denote by E naught the immediate parabolic base. And both Baker and Dominguez and Fajey and Hendriksen proved that the positive real line is contained in the immediate parabolic basin, and the negative real line is contained in the Julia set. And moreover, the map inside the immediate basin has degree two, and the inner function can be computed explicitly, and is this expression here. And it is obviously of doubly parabolic type, because it comes from a parabolic basin. Then if we take these results to the dynamical plane of F, first, we realize that F satisfies this relation in here, which means that we only have to study a strip of H 2 pi I to understand the dynamics everywhere. And moreover, we have that the lines with imaginary part multiple of pi are invariant by F, and they correspond when K is even to the positive real line of the previous function with the parabolic basin. So they are in the Fatou set, and are the ones in pink, and the ones in blue is when K is odd, and they correspond to the negative real line before, so they are in the Julia set. And in each strip delimited by two blue lines, we have a copy of the immediate parabolic basin, which is invariant because it contains the pink line, and the pink line was invariant. And this is a doubly parabolic Baker domain. And now we can restrict ourselves to a band of case 2πi because of this kind of symmetry. And so we consider S to be the one with imaginary pi in between minus pi and pi. And then we have that the map acts like this, no? So the upper lid is L plus, who has two preimages on the strip. One is itself because it was forward invariant, and the other one is this bended curve in here. So this region, this orange region in here, is mapped outside the strip, and the same for L minus. So this region in here is mapped also outside the strip, but the rest of the strip is mapped to the whole strip with degree 2. And then recall that we have our Baker domain in here, and this gray set in here is a possible absorbing domain for the function. So I recall that since we have a doubly parabolic Baker domain of degree 2, the map in the boundary is both ergodic and recurrent. So almost every orbit is dense. And this in particular means that the escaping set in the boundary of U has zero measure because its points have no dense orbit. And now we are going to describe these dynamics more explicitly. So first we're going to describe the accesses to infinity from U. So a point is said to be accessible, a point in the boundary of U is said to be accessible from U if there exists a curve contained in U such that the curve converges to ends at this point. And a homotopy class of such curves is called an axis. And Baker and Dominguez proved that the accesses from U to infinity are defined by the preimages of the positive real line and the rest. So the easy part of the proof is to see that the preimages of the positive real line define accesses. It's obvious that the positive real line defines an axis because it ends at infinity and it is all contained in our Baker domain. And since the preimage of a curve landing at infinity is also a curve landing at infinity, all the preimages of the positive real line define accesses to infinity. And the difficult part is to see that there are no more. And to deal with these kinds of problems, what we do is to consider the Riemann map between our Fatou component and the unit disk. And in this case, we're going to consider this, which sends 0 to 0 and the interval in between minus 1 and 1 to the real line. And because with this, the associated inner function is the one that I said before. But the important thing is that one was the Jové Campabadal point. So all orbits in U converge to infinity approaching the positive real line. And accesses to infinity are defined by the points in the unit circle which have radial limit equal to infinity. And it is proving that the accesses are the preimages of the positive real line is the same to prove that the points in the unit circle whose limit is infinity is this set of points which are preimages of one. And another interesting question, if there are points, periodic points in the boundary of the Baker domain. And first we proved that if we have a periodic point in the boundary, it must be accessible. So what we did to prove this is to construct a curve landing at this point using the branches of the appropriate branch of the inverse of f to the p to build this curve. And the thing is that although our map has infinitely many singular values, they are very controlled. So in our street, there is only one singular value, which is one, and it converges to infinity in the real line. So it is inside the Baker domain. So it's far from the periodic point, and we have the inverse well defined on it. So this does not answer the question of if there are periodic points in the boundary of the Baker domain. It only says that if they are accessible. And to deal with this existence, we have this theorem in here, which says that whenever we have a periodic point for G, so in the unit circle, that we have infinitely many because the map is conjugate to the doubling map, then the radial limit exists and is a periodic point of period P. And to prove this, what we did is to construct an invariant curve for G to the P landing at this periodic point, and then pass it to the to the Baker domain, and using Kevin's distortion theorem to prove that it has to land at a single point. And with these two theorems, we can characterize the periodic points in the boundary of U. So a point in the boundary of U is periodic if and only if it is the radial limit of a periodic point for G in the unit circle. And finally, we want to describe the escaping set in the boundary of U. So recall that we are considering these strip S, which are the points with imaginary part in between minus pi and pi. And we have that this orange region is mapped to the strip in a 2-to-1 fashion. So the points which eventually lie in these regions exit the strip. And to consider the escaping set, we are going to consider this other set S hat, which is precisely the set of points that never exit the strip. So that never enters to these regions. And since the map in the Baker domain has degree 2, so the Baker domain is clear in S hat because it is forward invariant. Then the only component of the Fatou set inside S hat is U, and the boundary of U is contained in the Julia set and S hat, but we already don't know if this is an equality, because there might be points which are not in the boundary of any Fatou components of these varied points, and they may be ones that never exit S, we don't know. Then in S, observe that we have two ways to escape to infinity, going to the right or going to the left. And these behaviors are, exclusive. So there are no oscillating sequence. Why? Because in the right, the map is very similar to the identity, because E to the Z has very small modulus. So a point which is escaping going to the right cannot turn to the left. So these both sets are disjoint. And the points escaping going to the right are only the ones in the Baker domain. Why? Because we have this gray region is the absorbing domain, so it is contained in the Baker domain, and points outside, so this line is in pi halves. Points outside are mapped to the left. So points outside the absorbing domain, so above the absorbing domain, cannot move going to the right. So this is why we have this equality here. And now, in the strip, the map had degree 2, so we can consider the two branches of the inverse, which are the ones painted. And one sense, all the strip to the upper half plane intersect with the strip, and the other to the lower. And we defined S0 and S1 to be precisely these two strips. And then for each point that never exits the strip S, one can consider a sequence, an itinerary of zeros and ones, depending of the of Fn, if Fn is in S0 or in S1. And with this, we can construct a curve. So given a sequence K of zeros and ones, we can construct a curve and whose points escape to infinity, but escape going to the left, which have itinerary K, and they are contained in the boundary of U. And to do this construction, we use similar arguments from the construction of the hairs for the exponential family of the band. And observe this thing that we had, that all the points in the Baker domain scale to infinity going to the right, but on the other hand, the points that we found are going to the left, to infinity. And this is all the things that we've done, but now we have more questions because we are still working with this function and there are more things that can be solved. And regarding the topology, we have found the accesses to infinity and we have characterized them by means of the inner function. And we have proved that all periodic points in the boundary are accessible. But there's this question here, which other points are accessible from U? So accessible points have full harmonic measure, and we have only found the periodic ones which have zero measure. So there are plenty of more accessible points that we can found. And the other question is regarding the non-accessible points, if they all scale to infinity or not. And this was conjectured in this paper, and we want to answer it. And regarding the dynamics, we have characterized the periodic points also by means of the inner function. And one question is if they are dense in the boundary of U. And regarding the curve of escaping points, we have constructed them, but so we have found curves of escaping points, but there are more escaping points, and we know that there are more escaping points, and we want to found them, and a way can be to pull back this curve until they land at some finite point or not, and then to use this to describe all the escaping set. And finally, we knew that the points with dense orbit have full harmonic measure, but we have not found explicitly any point having having a dense orbit. So we want to find them. And this is all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. A very interesting talk. Now it's time for questions, comments. I can provide with microphone.
Okay, so I have a question. So you said that on the boundary there's some recurrence and some ergodicity. So I was going to ask you if you know something about high order ergodicity. I mean, mixing, weakly mixing, something like that.
I don't know. So I have only studied ergodicity and recurrence.
Okay.
I don't know more things.
Okay, sorry. Thanks anyway.
I have a question. Do you believe that the components of the escaping set on the boundary of U are all homeomorphic to lines, or do you think it can contain nasty continua?
I think that they are homeomorphic to lines, but this is not a Cantor bouquet because we know that the L plus and the L minus. Oh, sorry, one moment. Here, the L plus and the L minus lines are in the boundary of U, and they are made of escaping points, and they are not curved at land at one point. So this is not going to be a Cantor bouquet. But I do think that they will be, all these lines will be homeomorphic to lines.
Okay.
Questions? If not, let's thank the speaker then.